Welcome to South Florida Saltwater Fishing. I'm Heath, and it's Tips and Tricks Thursday. You ever wanted to go out and fish for Mahi Mahi, but you just didn't know what to do, or even how to get started? Well, in this Tips and Tricks episode, I'm going to simplify this process. I'm going to go over how to fish for them, where to find them, and what to fish for them with. That's right, we're gonna go over the easiest way to catch Mahi Mahi. Before we get into this though, if you wanna learn more about fishing, grow as an angler, or just see some great and exciting offshore fishing adventures, you can start by hitting the subscribe button. And don't forget to turn on the notification bell so that you won't miss a thing. Okay, so to start out with, like I said, the easiest way to catch Mahi Mahi, hands down without a doubt, the most productive, easiest way to catch Mahi Mahi is by trolling. That means you're going to be pulling baits behind your boat. Along with trolling, you don't just want to throw lines in the water and troll over the open desert of the ocean. This is called blind trolling. Now granted, blind trolling does work periodically, but more often than not, you're going to want to look for signs of life. The most common sign of life to find Mahi Mahi under is weed lines. You're gonna find a weed line, you're gonna troll along it to see if there's any dolphin feeding on the prey fish that are swimming underneath it. Now, not every weed line holds dolphin. There's also other forms of structure out there floating on top that you can use. There's pallets, the random boat flipped upside down. There's all sorts of stuff where there's current breaks and wind breaks that happen naturally in the ocean. You'll wanna head to them and troll along them. That's where you're gonna find dolphin. The process of this is always a challenge to find the depth where the dolphin are hanging out. Weed lines sometimes hang out in different ranges depending upon the wind breaks of the atmosphere. Sometimes you'll find a weed line in 200 feet of water and there's nothing there. You find a weed line out in 400 or 500 feet of water and they're there. Then you'll find another weed line out in 800 feet of water and there's nothing there. That being said, once you find dolphin, you get into that hookup, that's the depth where they are. That's where the food is. They're feeding. They're always feeding. They're ultra hungry fish. They're always swimming and always migrating. This means they're always burning energy, so they always have to replace it by always eating. So, you find the food, you find the Mahi Mahi. And of course, another telltale sign of dolphin in the area is birds. Now, I want to tell you a secret about birds. If you see 10, 15, a whole pack of birds going crazy, actively feeding, that is not dolphin, that's tuna. If you see 1, 2, maybe 3 birds actively feeding, hitting the water, that's a sign of it being dolphin. If you see that one frigate way up in the air, 300 feet in the air, just circling around, don't even bother with him. He's wasting your time. He's looking for fish just like you are. All right, so now we know about the technique we're gonna go and try to catch Mahi Mahi with. That's trolling. We know what we're gonna look for. Signs of life, weeds, floating debris, birds. Now, I'm gonna go over my favorite baits to troll with them for. Personally, for me, the most productive baits to catch Mahi Mahi on is artificial lures. So, I'm gonna go over some of my favorites with you right now, and then we're gonna go over the tactics that you can employ to fish for Mahi with them. The first lure that I love to use is a white bucktail jig. You might ask yourself, hey, can you troll that really? Yes, you can. This is a 1/2 ounce white bucktail jig from the company Spro. You toss it behind the boat, you troll this puppy, and you will get the hookup with dolphin. Some of my other favorite types of lures are trolling skirts. Originally, these were made as additives to put on top of ballyhoo. But several years ago, I came up with the technique and I said, hey, I'm just gonna troll just a skirt with no ballyhoo behind it. I stuff a weight in the head, I hook it with a double hook setup, I put it on about 40 to 60 pound monofilament leader, I troll it behind the boat. You can use different colors. This is white, chartreuse, and blue, and this one is white and pink. They're both very productive. What you gotta do is you'll troll them around. You'll figure out which color the dolphin are more apt towards hitting, and then you will stick with that color. The next lure that I'm gonna go over is one of my favorite all-time trolling lures. It's a Billy Bait Mini Turbo Slammer in the color Pearl Blue. This is a 4.5-inch lure. It's hooked up with double 5.0 hook setup on 40-pound monofilament leader. This lure catches everything, but it especially slays the mahi. Along with the Billy Bait Mini Turbo Slammer, I can also turn it into a compound lure by adding on a 6-inch trolling squid behind it. I drop it down, and that gives it a larger profile. The bigger fish will go after this. The hungrier fish will go after this. Don't be afraid to get creative and think outside of the box when it comes to your trolling for dolphin. You don't have to use a lure the way it comes from the factory. Thinking outside of the box will definitely get you into the bite. And then there's also one of my more favorite trolling lures, which is an Islander. Now, I have this one hooked up as a compound lure. This is a blue and white Islander, and I have a pink and blue trolling squid hooked up behind it. And I have it hooked up to two long shank 10-0 hooks. This is on 80-pound monofilament. This is a little bit more of a heftier lure. You can troll it at faster speeds also. You have to be wary when you're using lures like this, or any lures for that matter, but more so the bigger, more enticing ones, you have to be wary that marlin will run up and hit it. Okay, so those are my favorite lures to troll for dolphin with. Now, you can also troll for dolphin with ballyhoo. It is a great time-tested bait. You can troll ballyhoo bare, just a ballyhoo in the water, or you can put one of these skirts in front of it, or you can put an Islander in front of it. Take your Islander, thread it onto your leader, toss the ballyhoo in the water, and troll that weed line, troll that debris, troll towards the birds. Okay, so all of this is good and dandy, but the one thing you don't want to do is wait until you're right upon the weed line or the debris or right underneath the birds to get your lines in the water. Make sure you got your lines in the water a quarter of a mile before you get to it. Troll up to it. The fish are not necessarily underneath it all the time. They are swimming around in it. They are pack hunters. They are corralling their food. So you may ask, okay, hey, I've got these lures. How fast do I go when I pull them? Speed is everything when you're trolling for dolphin. Dolphin are fast fish. They swim up to 30 knots, 40 knots when they're really hungry and chasing down bait. So don't be afraid to go more than 3 or 4 knots. Going slow when trolling gives a fish time to swim up and examine your bait. That is not what you want to do at all. Trolling is all about enticing the impulse to feed on an actively feeding fish, which means you're going to speed up. When you troll artificials, it is okay to do 8 to 10 knots. You don't want to do any less than 6 knots when trolling artificials for mahi. Make them chase you down. Trust me, you're not going to outrun them. If you are trolling ballyhoo, we're going to tone it down a little bit. Ballyhoo trolled behind a protective layer, like an Islander or a skirt, you'll want to tone it down to about 6 knots. Bare ballyhoo, no skirt, nothing. You're going to want to troll between 4 and 5 knots. Otherwise, you will wash out your bait. The next thing to clarify is how far do I let my lines out? Well, if you're trolling one line, let it out about 150 feet. If you're trolling two lines, you'll want to let one line out about 150 feet, another line out about 200 to 250 feet. You're going to let that long line out first. If you're on a smaller boat and you're feeling frisky and you want to troll a third line, you can. You let the third line out straight in the middle of your two lines and you let that out about 50 to 75 feet max, right behind the prop wash. You got to think, when a dolphin is chasing down your bait, they're not thinking your boat is a boat. They don't know what a boat is. It's something foreign to them. What it looks like from underneath the water is a big pot of bait traveling at a certain speed. And then behind them are your lures, which are the straggling baits, which present the easy target for the predators. So now we've gone over how we're gonna fish for mahi. We're gonna troll. We're gonna look for debris, weed lines, birds. That's where we're gonna find them. We're gonna use artificials, such as white bucktail jigs, trolling skirts, jet heads, such as Billy Bait Mini Turbo Slammers, or Islanders. Or we're gonna go with natural baits, such as ballyhoo. That's what we're gonna fish with them for. Now also when it comes to what we're gonna fish with them for is the gear. We're gonna go into that right now. All right, so when we're fishing for mahi-mahi, we're gonna wanna use medium to heavy gear. You can always troll for mahi-mahi with spinning gear, just like this. This is a Penn Spinfisher 8500. It's spooled with 20-pound test from the company Momoi. It's in the color smoke blue. It is on a star rod, a 7-foot rod from the Paraflex series. This will handle big dolphin, no problem. Don't get it wrong and say, oh, it's a spinner, how do you do that? How do you troll with it? I troll with spinners all day for dolphin. And now where the Spinfisher 8500 is a heavier class outfit for spinning reels, you can also use medium class rods and reels such as this. This is a Diawa black and gold 60. It's on a 6'6" custom chaos rod. This is a great setup. I catch dolphin with it all day, big ones too. You can catch big bull dolphin on this rod. Now, the thing about fishing with spinners is every once in a while you will get something else, some other predator to come up and eat your trolling lure. You get a wahoo, or you'll get the occasional marlin that will come up and tear into one of these spinners. So you have to be vigilant and think, am I willing to put up the fight and go after that big pelagic fish should it come up and hit one of my spinners? My answer is usually yes, but I've learned plenty of lessons where I've hooked things like blue marlin on spinners. This one in particular. The next gear that we can use is light class conventional reels, such as this. This is a Penn 12H. It's from the International series. I have this on a 7-foot star rod from the handcrafted series. It's spooled with 20-pound test. This rod has great shock absorbency. A rod like a spinning rod or a lightweight conventional rod, you want it to have a lot of shock absorbency. Remember, you're not setting the hook. The fish sets the hook for you when he grabs the lure and takes off the other way. Your monofilament stretches, your rod bends, and that's what pulls the hook back towards you in a negative fashion and sets it in the bones of their mouth. Light conventional reels, great for mahi fishing. And the last but the safest way to fish for mahi, of course, is the medium to heavy class conventional reels. This is a Penn International 30. It's on a 7-foot AFCO rod. Great setup for catching big pelagic fish. Using this, if you get tagged by a wahoo or a marlin, you're gonna be just fine. So, those are the setups that I like to use and I think are the best ways to troll for mahi-mahi. Spinners and conventional reels. And if you're playing it safe, I would definitely go with bigger gear. That way, if the big pelagics come along, you're prepared. All right, folks, so there you have it in a nutshell. How to catch mahi-mahi. We're gonna troll for them. We're gonna troll towards debris, like weed lines. Flotsam. We're gonna look for birds. We're gonna troll for them with natural baits like ballyhoo or artificial lures. We're gonna fish with these baits out back of the boat at least 150 to 200 feet away. And we're gonna troll them at the speeds of 6 to 10 knots. And we're gonna use medium to heavy spinning gear or light to medium conventional gear to troll for mahi. And what we're gonna do is once we find them, we're gonna stay at that depth until they stop biting and we can't find them no more. Because that's where they are for that day. That's where the food is and that's where they're feeding. All right, folks, that about does it for this episode. I hope you had fun, hope you enjoyed, and I hope you learned a little bit about what I consider to be the most productive and easiest way to catch mahi-mahi. Till next time, South Florida saltwater fishing, going wherever the cool wind takes us.